equal to 3x squared minus 1. And similarly, we can find all other factorials, means all other polynomials. And for the moment, these are sufficient. And now we go to the associated Legendre polynomials. Because we want to have the values of not only L, but for every L there is an associated value of M as well. So coming back to this equation, and here I will have for when L is equal to 0. When L is equal to 0, the very first value, and we know that P naught of x is equal to 1. So here, put L equal to 0, then come here, 1 minus x squared, we will decide the m value later, dv dx m, and here it will become P naught of x, and P naught of x is 1. So whatever the value here, we will have here, I am having a constant. So the constant value means any derivative of this will give you 0. But if I consider the only value which is m equal to 0, means for each L, m will run from 0 to all values. So for the very first value of L, which is 0, m 0 value is the first value. So put here m equal to 0. So this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. So 1 multiplied 1, 1, and I will get that P 0, 0, x is also equal to 1. Now, go to the next value of m. Let's consider plus 1. Now, is here the m is absolute. So, if we consider plus minus m, it will be the same, or plus and minus. But values, the number of values will be different, but the value will come out to be the same. If m is equal to 0, we got 1 here, 0, 0, and 1. If m is equal to 1, then here it will become 1 minus x square 1 over 2, d over dx 1. Here, pl of x, this is p naught is 1. So, any differential of a constant will give us 0. So, for the only possible value here, is 0, and 0 is possible only, while all other values will give us 0. So let me say that the m, when m will be greater than l, like l is 0 here, and m is greater than this, like 1, 2, 3, or so on, then I will get these values equal to 0. P, L, M of X will be equal to 0. All other higher values will be equal to 0. So, if I consider minus 1, now minus 1 here again will come 1 over 2, again it will come 1, and again we will have this thing equal to 0. So when I can then write that when m absolute is greater than l, we will get all high values equal to zero. Now this is equal to 1, and now come to for L equal 1. When L is equal to 1, I know that P1 of X is equal to X. P1 of X is equal X. So for L equal to 1, now start with all possible values of M. So for L equal to 1, the possible values of L will be up to plus minus 1, because for plus minus 2, M will become greater than L, and we will have this thing equal to 0. So let's check this again, that the first value we try, M equals 0, so we will have P1 0. P1 here and 0 here. So 1 minus x squared to the power 0, this is equal to 1. And then d over dx to the power 0, and this is again 1. And here P1 of x is equal to x, so we got x here. And x, we know that this is equal to cos of theta. Similarly, when m is equal to plus 1, then P1 of 1 will be equal to 1, 1. So it will be 1 minus x squared 1 over 2. It will be d over dx 1, so d by dx, and P1 of x is equal to x. So this will come out to be, d by dx of x. D by dx of x will become 1. So we will have 1 minus x squared, and this will come out to be 1. Now when I write this thing, 1 minus x squared, now 1 minus x squared, x is equal to cos theta, so 1 minus, and this is having a square root as well, half here from here. So 1 minus x squared, 1 minus cos squared theta, 1 minus cos squared theta is sine squared theta, sine squared theta with this, with square root simplifies, and then this thing is equal to sine of theta. Similarly, when m is minus 1, p1 of minus 1 will be again the same thing, 1 minus x squared. We know in classical electrodynamics is one of the assignment, this was proved that pln will be of x is equal to pl minus m of x. So these two values will come out to be the same, while number of values will be different. So here, if I now consider, means this is done, for m equal to 2, then it will, m will come out to be greater than l, and we know that this will come out to be 0. We can see this from here, that PL of x is x squared, so it is 2 times L, and here is the lth derivative. So L will cancel this L in the differentiation, and only 2 comes out to be here. And when this thing becomes equal to 2, it will give us a constant, and for more than 2, it will come out to be 0. So now let's go with this one, that what about the, for L equal to 2, then for n equal to 2, we are having the value half 3x square minus 1. Then when n is equal to 2, then m should not be greater than 2. And we will have the m values is 0 plus minus 1 and plus minus 2 only, and not this one. So we can prove the other polynomials as well. But let us simplify this thing, that p 0, 0 of x was equal to 1, p 1, 0 is equal to x, which is equal to cos theta, and p 1 of 1 is equal to, we got 1 minus x square by 2 half, and this we got equal to sine theta. So the associated Legendre polynomial, the first value is 1, the second value is cos theta, the third value is sine theta, and so on. We can find for all other values. Here we will have to summarize a little bit, and that is that big theta is a function of theta, means the wave function which depends on theta, the zenith angle. The solution was a p, the associated Legendre polynomial PLM of x are cos theta, we can convert them, where L was equal to some integral values, while we proved that M absolute will always be less than L for getting some values. When M will become greater than L, we will have zero values of these polynomials. Now here, when L was equal to 0, we got one value of M. And when L was equal to 1, we got 1, 2, 3 values of M. So I can write that if this is when L is 1, when L is 1, then I will have its value is plus, the M values will be plus and minus 1. So my plus 1 here and minus 1 here, and 0 will be in between for the M values. And this way I can write that when M will be, when L will be equal to 2, then I will have 0 here, plus 1 here, plus 2 here, and on this side minus 1, minus 2 here. And for each value of L, we will have 2 L plus 1 values for M. When L is 0, we got 1 value, means 2 into 0, 0. So 1 value for M here. When L is equal to 1 here, we got 3 values of M, 2 into 1 plus 1. So 2, these, this end, and the plus 1 is actually this 0. When L will be equal to 2, then we will get 5 values of M. So for each value of L, we are having 2 L plus 1 values for M. And I can further generalize this one, that this M values will be actually from minus L to minus L plus 1, and then some other values, and then 0 will come in, and then we will have 1 and up to plus L. So the m values will run from minus l to plus l, where 2l plus 1 values with us. Now, the normalization constant that we wrote here, we will have to determine this, and we can get some clues for the determination of this from the electrodynamics values. We will have to normalize our wave function, and we know to normalize our wave function psi squared, and it will be d tau, and d tau is psi mod square. D tau is actually d cube. R are the volume element in spherical polar coordinates, is psi mod square, and this is r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. So I can write, if I want to write this in terms of capital R and capital Y, then this will be capital R square is our wave function. So R square will come with this from the volume element, and dr will come with this into integral. This is the radial integral, and this is the angular integral, and this will be capital Y mod square, and the volume element sine theta d theta d phi will come with this d theta and d phi. So individually means there's a whole, this will come out to be one, but this individually should come out one, and the angular portion individually should come out to be one. And the final, this is from the terms of polynomial. When we find out the values of the index L and M, this is for the theta, while for the phi we are having E, I and phi, and if we determine this constant A as well, then I will write that Y L M from here, Y L M is, Y is a wave function which is a combination of theta and phi. So I will write theta and phi, and this is equal to the constant, this normalization constant is equal to epsilon 2L plus 1 and L minus M absolute whole factorial divided by 4 pi and L plus M absolute whole factorial, and this is inside a square root. Then E, I, M, phi is the azimuthal component, and P, L, M is the P, L, M is the associated Legendre polynomial of cos theta, where epsilon is a constant, and it is minus 1 to the power M when M is positive, and it is equal to 1 when M is negative. So these are the normalized angular wave functions, and these normalized angular wave functions we call the spherical harmonics. So these are the spherical harmonics, which we will discuss further in the coming lectures.